Atom, from the Greek words a, meaning not, and temnein, to cut, because it was thought that atoms were unbreakable and utterly unshakable. No part of them was takeable, their oneness unmistakeable. But now we know they're breakable, and we do it quite a lot. An astronaut has trillions of atoms, and that's just in a single strand of armpit hair. So hold on to your noses and let us see what happens if we take a trip in there. A-T-O-M, impossible to count cause there's so many of them. A-T-O-M-I-C, so small that they are totally impossible to see. So let's dive down to the depths of the atom. It's a world so wild that it's difficult to fathom. The tiny things whizzing round the outside are electrons 5 or 6 femtometers wide. A simple fact that you've got to embrace is that most of an atom is empty space. If an atom was as big as Westminster Cathedral, the nucleus would be a baby bee busy buzzing in the middle. A-T-O-M, impossible to count cause there's so many of them. A-T-O-M-I-C, so small that they are totally impossible to see. Now back to the B. That B is made of hadrons, which are protons, or neutrons, which are held together with the help of gluons. Now we're getting quite advanced for the brightest sparks. But hadrons actually consist of quarks. And of what sort of things do those quarks comprise? Well, if you can tell us that,
you can tell us that
you win the Nobel Prize. A-T-O-M, even air is literally swarming with them. A-T-O-M-G, I can't believe that there are also many, many trillions of those things in me.